Howdy folks, welcome back to the channel and to a new toy room. This is where I have been for the past couple of weeks. If you folks haven't been joining me on several live streams that I've done over the past week and a half, I've basically been showing off bits and pieces of the new project, which is a bigger, more, I guess, convenient Alien Predator room for myself. You know, the last bedroom that I was in was becoming way too cramped. You know, the more stuff I put in there, the more difficult it becomes to unbox things and just make just regular videos like I am now. So, took about 3 weeks, but I finally moved into here. I got everything in, I got everything set up, and I'm ready to finally make more content. And we're gonna start out with this beauty. Finally. I can't tell you guys, you folks, how long I've been searching for this particular item. The NECA Toys Ultimate 40th Anniversary Big Chap Alien. Much like the Alien 3 creature pack, which eluded me at my local Targets and Walmarts for ever, they just never made it to my area, this gal did it again. Did the very same thing. And I don't know why, they just refused the stock of this item. We have plenty of Godzillas, plenty of Bob Ross figures, which I forgot NECA was doing. Let's get a closer look at this gal here. And many more. Horror figures, no turtles, no, we're not that lucky, but look at that. That detail on everything. I can't wait to unbox this. I've been waiting for this figure for so flippin' long. Granted, I do have the quarter scale version, but this one comes with the new face hugger, the new egg, and whatnot. So, I thought I'd just do a little bit of an unboxing today. Because, again, I don't want to wait any longer. I just want to open this. And what are we opening it with today? My cutting tool. Yeah, so if anybody tries coming in here with negative intentions, I actually have two of them on the desk, just in case, because that's just smart. Alright, let's open this gal. Come on. Please don't be broken, by the way. I really don't want you to be damaged. I really don't want you to be damaged, because I don't have anywhere to exchange you with, and I don't really feel like putting you back together with super glue. Gotta tell you that much. So. Yeah, I hope you guys like the new background, by the way. I know it's kind of dark, but I do have the alien rug there. I got the video game shelf and whatnot. And let me know how the sound is, by the way. I have my window open and I have the fan on. And my camera's very, very powerful when it comes to audio. So if it's too loud, let me know in the comments and I can adjust it for the next video. So, here we have the base, right here. The tendrils and vines, if you will. So the base for the alien egg. That's pretty nice. Kind of a brittle plastic, to tell you the honest truth, but it's not too bad. It's not too bad. So it's gonna be laying flat. I doubt anything will happen to it. I think we should be in good shape. Let me move my bobblehead off. All right. Now, I'm going to cut here so I can open the twisty ties because it's going to take me a year. Got the egg out. Oh, wow. So, there is no bottom. I didn't know that. Check that out. Okay. I mean, it doesn't really matter considering it's just going to plug in to this thing here. So, how does this work? Okay, I see. So it kind of grooves in here. Let's see how well. Okay. Yeah, it actually looks really cool. So finally, we get an alien egg that's accurate to the 79 film. Finally, let's get a better view on that. Sorry if it's incredibly bright, but I do have the LED lights in front of me. Closer than usual. Here's the inside. So that actually works. Yeah. Alright, cool. I'm glad they went this route, because a lot of companies would honestly just give you the vines and tendrils separately and you have to plug them in. I'm glad it's just two separate pieces and it's plain and simple. So, All right, let's get the face hugger out here because I haven't watched any reviews on this figure, and I'm wondering if the legs on the face hugger are movable. And I hope that it is, but something's telling me, nah, they're not. I mean, they're pliable, but it's not like the tail where there's a metal wire in them. But I really do dig this new mold. It has quite a bit of detail. Let's try to get you in there. So it's nice looking. I'll be doing a proper review of this figure, so I'll save all my thoughts for that, but it's nice. It's really nice. And so you can just pop out like that. Good. So this is the face hugger that gets Kane too. So now we have the specific figure of the face hugger. And now we have the chest burster, also specific to Kane, which is to a new mold, correct? I believe so. Oh, that's cool looking. Check this out. Gosh, you probably guys can't even see, but there you go. So she's covered in blood and everything, which I think is pretty cool, and she's screaming and whatnot. I got the bendy tail as well, which is pretty cool. So, you know, when I look at this, I just think about Spaceballs. if you guys know what I'm talking about. All right, now for the big girl herself. I am nervous. I am very nervous because I don't have the best luck when it comes to Xenomorph figures by NECA. Most of them have issues. I mean, I guess you can say the same thing with most of NECA's stuff, but I just have exceptionally bad luck with their aliens. And I really, like I mentioned earlier, I don't want to break anything because this thing was so hard to get on my end. I had to hunt real hard, but hold on, give me a sec. Alright, moment of truth. I also have bad luck when it comes to loose joints, because the last big chap I got, that thing, nothing can save it. So, here she is, out of the package, and I'm going to be real careful here. We're going to go one joint at a time, folks. The paint is real nice on her, I gotta tell you. Okay, this arm is extremely stiff, so I'm gonna be careful with that. So far, I mean, I'll take stiff joints like this that can hardly even move compared to the loose joints, because those are a nightmare. So, yeah, I mean, I can feel quite a few of these these stiff joints. Not too bad at the moment. Man, that feels real loose. I mean, not loose, real fragile. I am so scared. She is definitely gonna need the hot water treatment, but I'll mess with that later on. Here we have the tail, so it does rotate. That's kind of cool. Yeah, see this leg? Right here? That makes me real nervous. That's gonna need hot water because I think the joint is frozen, but the peg that goes into the thigh is very loose. Or is it? Yeah, it is. Hold on. I want to make sure, but she looks beautiful. I gotta tell you. Real nice. Let's open the mouth and let's get the inner mouth out. That was actually very easy. Didn't expect that. Gorgeous piece. She is really nice. Finally, you are in the collection. I have been wanting you forever, but you just kept eluding me. The amount of Targets and Walmarts I hit up during our fun little quarantine was just nuts. How many Targets I called asking for her, but finally I got her in hand. And again, she's definitely gonna need some hot water treatment. That's fine. I'm used to it. I'm glad that there's nothing serious wrong with the figure, and she's awesome looking. So, and this makes me even more excited for Dallas that's coming out, the Ultimate Ripley and the prototype Xenomorph, or the prototype Big Chap of her. And of course, Brett and Dallas and Ash and all those fun peeps coming out. So, good job, NECA. Good job. This is on par with your quarter scale, and your quarter scale was basically perfect. So, it's nuts. Like, this is the definitive mini version of the quarter scale. Like, all the detail you see on the quarter scale is on her. It's nuts how well of a job they did. And I'm not sponsored by NECA, in case you're wondering. I'm not, but you know, I know it sounds like I'm sucking their wiener here. I'm sucking their wiener a little bit, but it really is a good figure. So there you go. And that is that with the unboxing. I will get started on a review soon. And for the folks who are interested in the new toy room, don't worry. I will be producing a new room tour, which is not going to be 4 hours in length. For the folks who are new to the channel, I did make a 4-hour collection tour of the last room that I was in, the last bedroom, and I commend all of you, for those of you that made it through all 4 hours, because I worked hard on that video, took forever to edit, as you can imagine, and it's awesome that it was as popular as it was. Go check out Trophy Room on Facebook, a Facebook group created by yours truly, made for alien predator collectors and enthusiasts like yourselves, you know, like myself. Please feel free to post about your collections, the lore, whether it's the comics, the movies, the toys, whatever it may be. Just one rule, don't be a dick. And as always, people, have a good morning, evening, midday, whatever, and take care.